the main event. Ryan Couture fighting Jimmy Spicuzza. This should be a terrific fight. Everybody's been waiting to see this fight. And really, we talk about a main event on the amateur level. This is as good as it gets.
This is as good as it gets, and I am really stoked about this fight. You know, Couture brings a lot to the table, so does Jimmy. So we're looking at a pretty good amateur fight right here, and I am excited.
All right, Ryan Couture, of course, you know his famous dad, Randy, and Ryan went to school up in the Northwest, got a degree in mathematics, had that wrestling background, always kind of felt that he could do something in this sport. So he decided to pursue this thing. He won here at the Mardi Gras Ballroom about 3-4 months ago. Fought again, now he's back for more. He is 2-1. You can't be trained by a better guy than Randy, and the guy's in at the Extreme Couture Gym, so he knows what he's doing in the ring.
That's true. And to be trained over there, I can tell you firsthand, is great. I'm a member myself. I'm a fighter out of that gym. We got good hard work there, and Ryan's put all that good hard work in, and we'll see what he's going to bring to the table against Jimmy tonight. And his wrestling skills are good. His striking skills are good. He's really improved since his last fight. I'm really excited to see this.
All right, 26-year-old Ryan Couture, who has his degree, as we mentioned. He's a math major. He's going to try to work some magic in the ring tonight against Jimmy Spicuzza. Jimmy from Chicago, Illinois, but now here in Las Vegas, went to Palo Verde High School. This guy is an all-around athlete.
Well, we're going to find out, aren't we? If Ryan's good at math, we're going to be able to see if he can keep up with the count of how many punches he lands on this guy tonight, huh?
That's right. We'll see what kind of equations that he comes up with against a guy named Jimmy Spicuzza. Jimmy Spicuzza is 3-1 with a couple of knockouts. His last one coming in on May 10th of this year. So, yeah, Spicuzza, the Palo Verde High School grad, who really is just an all-around athlete.
Yeah, so we got a hometown boy. Sounds like he's got a lot of people behind him, Jimmy. So he's got a lot of support, but so does Couture.
You talk about the support. I mean, just look into the ring, the corner of Ryan Couture. You got Randy over there. You got
you got Sean Tompkins
over there as well. And then with Jimmy Spicuzza, I think I saw Blas Avena, who of course was a WEC fighter as well. So this is going to be a great fight. And how about this? I mean, Jimmy's got a lot of fans. He's from Las Vegas, and the Couture name speaks for itself. So
yeah, that's true. The only way to find out is after that bell and when those two guys touch gloves, if they do touch gloves, and then we're going to find out.
I think so.
The Spicuzza clan includes 102 family friends that have come to this fight here.
Oh,
tonight.
Wow. Wow. What a count.
I mean, you can hear the electricity inside the ring. Look at all the red on the backside of Jake Gutierrez behind him. That is a clan. Look at that. That's amazing.
This is going to be a heck of a fight.
I'd love to see the camera guys get a shot at it. That's amazing, the amount of people that he has behind him here inside of the Mardi Gras Ball Red Circle.
And here's Jake Gutierrez.
Ladies and gentlemen, Barry Meyer and Tuff-N-Uff Productions, in association with the Orleans Hotel and Casino, is proud to present our featured bout of the evening, scheduled for 3 2-minute rounds in the 155-pound division. This bout is supervised by the Nevada State Athletic Commission. Chairman is Bill Brady, and sanctioned by the ISKA President Corey Schaefer. The ISKA representative is Ralph Cook. Our scorekeeper is Carlos Cantone. Timekeeper is Bridget Mazzagatti. The three judges scoring this bout will be Troy Mazzagatti, Mark Smith, and Joel Sullivan. And when the action starts, our referee in charge is Chris Tione. And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the Orleans Hotel and Casino, right here in exciting Las Vegas, Nevada, it's time for the leather to fly. This is the main event. Introducing first, he fights out of the red corner. He entered the ring wearing black trimmed in red, and he is fighting for Extreme Couture. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting Ryan Couture. And across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner, he's wearing black and white, and he represents Excel Defense Team Makeup. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Jimmy Spicuzza.
One thing about Jimmy Spicuzza is he gets up extremely early in the morning, runs a restaurant cleaning business so that he can train all day long. He's been waiting for this fight for 8 months.
And he's ready for it. I'm not gonna lie to you, Chris. I have never heard the Mardi Gras ballroom this loud before for a fight.
This is the main event, and it should be a thrilling fight. I mean, we're anticipating. Look at these fans.
Looks like Couture has got the reach on Spicuzza, so Couture needs to stay on the outside, try to work that strike and, until he can find an open for his wrestling.
Here we are. And just looking at the two fighters, Spicuzza looks a little bit more muscular. Looks like he's quick on his feet with his boxing.
Couture stopping him down. Nice little jab there. Jimmy with a nice fast jab there.
That was a very quick jab.
You better go with that high kick. Couture should go with a high kick now because Spicuzza's reaching down when he kicks.
You're right. You go down lower. Even the old adage, look down low, come up top.
Nice exchange there.
Ryan did a good job of staying in the pocket and catching Spicuzza with the left.
Spicuzza coming in with a George St. Pierre move, if you will.
One thing I like that Spicuzza is doing, he's throwing some space. And I think he might be overexerting himself. Looks like he's a little bit out of it. Ooh.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time of 1 minute 22 seconds of the first round. The winner by armbar submission, Ryan Couture!
All right, so congratulations to Ryan, who improves to 3-1, and a big, big win over Jimmy Spicuzza here.
Big win.
Tonight.
Big win. And how about the fight before where the fighter didn't feel like he... his knee wasn't actually down, and he actually felt like his knee was up, and it was a fair knockout, and he went and gave the belt to the other guy. How about that?
Yeah, it's been a terrific night. The sportsmanship,
very good
you
night.
See it here tonight. You see it throughout these fights here. Tough enough, another terrific fight card
always
in Las Vegas.
Ryan Couture earns a win via armbar after being hurt, after hurting his opponent. That was a very back-and-forth fight, an exciting fight. One of the best fights I've seen, if you add the energy, ever in Tuff-N-Uff.
How about that exchange? One guy's hurt, the other guy's hurt, one guy's hurt, they both.
It was awesome.
Yeah. Oh,
wow. Rock'em sock'em robots.
Oh man. Wow. Once again, Barry Meyer does a terrific job of putting together a fight card that the fans want to see. It was an electric night. You mentioned they had 100 fans for Spicuzza, a whole bunch of fans behind us for Couture, and it ends up being a thrilling finish.
It was.
That was a great finish.
I am always excited to be here.
Mike.
And next time, I hope to be here again so I can observe all these fights because they are dynamite always.
I agree.
All right, so you see in the ring now, you see Ryan along with Randy, his dad, and there's Ron Frazier, the new papa, and they're enjoying a terrific night here at the Mardi Gras Ballroom at the Orleans Hotel and Casino. So from all of us, behind the scenes, the Capels Productions guys, you do a great job putting this thing together.
Wonderful job.
Mike Pyle, Brian Solomon, I'm Chris Matthews. Good night, everybody, from the Orleans. Until next time, we'll see you.
Good night.